Hello everyone.
Hi,
this is Devrina
and Prakriti here,
and today we've come up with a video on helpful and not so helpful thoughts.
Exactly, the kind of thoughts which go on in our heads, you know. Did you know, Devrina, what kind of thoughts you think?
See Prakriti, theoretically yes, mm-hmm. but on a regular basis, automatically no.
Because you know, the kind of thoughts we think really have a big impact on our day. About what we are feeling.
True, true. You're right on that.
Can you share an example?
Say, I'll give you an example. Again, because something that we do it on a regular basis, randomly, all of us, you, me, all of us do it. Say, you're out in the sun and you're not wearing your sunblock and you just, like, you know, you're out in the scorching sun. What happens? You start thinking of the worst. You think that these UV rays are going to affect your skin.
Absolutely.
You think that, like, you know, you might have skin cancer. To all kinds of things.
Exactly. Or you're going to be so freckled that your skin is always going to be bad. And we are, sometimes you're conscious, sometimes you're completely unconscious of it.
And your skin is going to go beyond repair.
Yes.
So this is a very, very catastrophizing thought.
Absolutely. So that brings us, you know, some thoughts are helpful and some thoughts are unhelpful. We always classify thoughts as right or wrong. Like in your example, I may think, Devrina, it's wrong to think like this. How can you say that? But at some level, you know, it's backed by some information. That's why you're so scared about UV rays. So a better way to look at it is my way of thinking helpful to my daily routine or it's not helpful? If it's helpful, I could call it a PET, you know, a performance enhancing thought. If it's not helpful, I could call it a PIT, something which brings me down, a performance inhibiting thought.
Totally. This takes us to another unhelpful thought, that is all or none way of thinking.
Absolutely. Either I come first in my class, otherwise I'm not a good student.
Either I am completely loved by everyone or I'm the most hated person on earth.
Either I reach a particular way, then I'm beautiful, and if I don't reach it, oh my god,
then I'm the ugliest being.
Absolutely.
This whole extreme oscillation that we do is so unhelpful to us. If only we realize that this thought, unhelpful thought that we're talking about, whom is it unhelpful to? Another? No. It's unhelpful to me.
Exactly. And over time, when I'm just indulging in these kind of unhelpful thoughts, I develop a faulty thinking system.
Totally.
The next one is catastrophizing. Oh my god, what's going to happen?
The world will come crumbling down.
Yes. Somebody yells at me, that means that's the end of my relationship.
I have a fight with my friend.
Mm-hmm.
And we think that we're never going to talk. So that relationship with this other person is ended there and then and for life.
Yes.
And how I'm going to be miserable without this friend of mine. And we go on to thinking of the worst.
Yes. And it's really crazy. And the third one that we talk about is how we blame another.
We blame another for all our miseries.
Yes.
All the things that are good that happened to us has been a result of our efforts. But anything bad that happens
is because of you. If only he was nicer to me, I would be so happy. If only my friend was just like me, I would be so happy.
We blame anybody, everybody, including the weather.
Yes. Or otherwise what we do, the fourth faulty way of thinking is magnification or minimization.
Suppose, I'd like to speak on minimization. Maximization, okay. I'm sure, like, you know, this, you'll talk about it later.
Okay.
Minimization would be, there is some crisis, there is something that needs your attention, but very often what do? We try and push it under the carpet, we try and not look at it, thinking that if I don't look that side, it'll go away.
Yes. And how do we magnify it? Social media, 5 people like it, I start believing that I'm the next trendsetter and thought leader in the world. We just magnify people's approval of us or disapproval of us.
Totally.
Think about it. And the next one that we talk about is mind reading.
You're doing this all the time.
Yes.
Without understanding that a lot of times when we don't spell out things, it's just a matter of assumption. It's never then an exact assumption. It's never on...
Yeah,
on
and it's never based on facts, you know. Like for example, sometimes, often it happens to us. We see people and they look through us. What do we think? My God, she's somebody who doesn't like me. Perhaps she's not wearing her spectacles or her lenses.
As simple as that.
Yeah. And the last one is overgeneralization. You know, we just go on generalizing. If I'm cycling and I fall down, I think I can never ride a bike. Does it happen to you?
All the time. All of us do this. And funny thing is, this is not just you, me. This is a universal truth that all of us tend to do all of these.
Yes. So how we could really deal with it is actually, if we kept a thought journal, if you could actually just catch our thoughts and see if they are helpful or unhelpful to us, we would really feel better about our day.
Instead of thinking what other people are thinking.
Absolutely. So on this note, here's to helpful thoughts to a lot more pets to you rather than pets. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.